Good morning, Matthew here, chilling out in sweet Jamaica. Just a very chill, regular kind of morning on the yard. There is a special guest here. It is Sunrise TV, Jason, aka Sunrise Boss. You might have seen his channel, does tons of vlogs on YouTube. And yeah, they went to go visit the bath fountain. I was chilling out, flying the drone. And this is just a very typical morning, hanging out on the yard. So I'm gonna go see what everyone's up to. I think Ratty's around. Pretty sure Mokko was probably sitting in his favorite chair right now. So let's go see what's up this morning. Sunny Hill.
Sunrise!
Yeah.
Morning.
Morning.
How are you doing, sir?
Yeah, man, I'm good, man.
How was the fountain?
Oh, yeah, bath. Man. The bath, good, man. You have to come check it out, man. The early morning experience, it's nice, man. But Mokko bring on around, they got sap on done. It's nice, and you know, sir, you just come from around and you reach a yard and you want to deal with some breakfast.
Mm.
You have fries, two dumplings, and steam some cabbage.
Nice.
So, just tune in for that. That we are dealing with them now.
Morning, Mokko.
Yes, sir.
What's happening?
Man, quite a good speech, you know.
It's that time of day.
Yeah.
What time were you guys up and moving?
Well, yeah. 5 o'clock that morning.
What?
Yeah. And the day this time. Because the girl like the water and like the option and like everything. So, you know, I go and go there and nobody now put somebody from when you want. If you want to sleep there. When you want to come home, you don't have got food. And got enough energy in your free and the mosquito then.
Mosquito?
What do you mean? When you go there, we don't feel them.
No?
But after to, yeah, fuck. Me, I feel them as thin me them, man. Me, I say, oh dear. Too soon, me them drink the tea, you won't come feed off of me.
You can sense the sweetness in the blood.
Yeah, and sense the sweet perfume blood in what I mean. But me, the captain rod, it make you know me not in a sleep. Bop! You think me asleep? What the fuck? Mosquito like this. Put up my bed, I'm in there. And I see the mosquito come. First, he goes so, within skin. Take time and I feel car white, a white sheet in the sunrise.
Yeah.
And the mosquito go the whole over there and bite every stick. Bite every weird panic kind of thing, somebody under there. And I see when he come out back, me, I watch him. I say, yo, you never breathe again if you go back and go pan no sheep look. One lick me game. Yeah, man. Can I stand up and see him? I'll do it like, boy, make me search this sheep, no? Make me search this place. Definitely if nobody underneath it. That's just then something that I'm wise.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, I say, man, well. Yeah, me saying, taking time, me saying, come on, come on. Zzzz, and go right pan it down. The whole round pan the bed, the mosquito, I joke. With instincts of the Lord, I see him come back out, let me say, you see you? You go dead, you know.
Yeah.
Party.
Yeah, come.
Yeah, time come, I didn't come up, me this fuck him up, man. You feel up my sheet too much from my bed like I'm here, one if you come kill. And if then sit there, could I kill you, you know? Where you think he might bite up it, though? Kill you.
Oh! Perfect timing. So Ratty, what are you up to here? So this was all a nice looking pool, decorated and everything. And you were keeping fish in here?
Yeah.
Yeah? So we had quite a bit of rain last night and it, I guess it fell, mashed it up from up top here. So that's good, Ratty. Fixing it up, patching it up. I wonder if there's a better spot we can move it so it doesn't get hit by the rain falling off the roof. So how do you make your little, your concrete here? I saw you mixing it up before.
With some water.
Water?
And some stone.
Water, stone, dirt?
Yeah.
That's it?
Yeah. And paint. And paint on the top.
Paint on the top, yeah.
Let it dry. Yeah. Mr. Scrappy. Get like a bit, like a bit. The hardest bit around.
So we pick some tom-tom and put it in here. How long does it take to dry off so it's nice and solid?
Not pretty long.
Not too long?
No.
Like after a day?
Yeah. I need to button it up.
Mm-hmm. Clever, man. Got sunrise boss here.
Yeah.
No, dumpling style.
Yeah, I'm gonna start knead up the floor and I calabash.
Mm, that's a big bash, holy.
Yeah, man, you know, Ross kitchen, me get you, know. Ross, son. Yeah, man. You know, my son go look some calabash. I'm gonna tell you, say, yeah, my man, a big one, I can't do anything. See, eh? Me, I need flour right now.
Yeah.
And if chicken fi season up, you can season up night same way. Yeah. I just, so me start knead the flour. Me use a spoon. And then after me use my hand and finish it, and just start it off with a spoon.
Are you into the flat dumplings or the spinners?
No, I think I'm gonna make some long one.
And anything else goes in these dumplings, or no? It's just straight flour.
It's flour, straight flour, water. Flour, cornmeal, water, baking powder, and a little salt.
Nice. That is the big bash, man. I don't think I've seen one like that around here.
True, man. When I see it, I'm like, whoa, man, I need it.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, two of them. And start use one of the next one. Yeah. So your flour come out now?
Yeah, yeah.
You don't need in flour, so you want it. You don't need it for sticky off your. Yeah, man.
So you can see, just a little bit of cornmeal for that color in there.
Yeah.
See? Sometimes people do straight flour ones too, right?
Yeah, well, to be honest, me like when cornmeal like
that. Yeah, me too. I like it with a little salt.
They say when a straight flour, when I go bathroom, you're kind of hard for you. You go to something there, you see? They say if you don't mix it with cornmeal, you know, that's what happens. So me always mix it with cornmeal.
Excellent.
And if I white flour, you know, so I can't really need white flour. If I try to need white flour, I pour it. Like if I just the source of flour with salt and water, I pour it. Pour it.
Now here comes the technique.
Oh yeah, well I saw me have a deal with my flour, and I'm just pop off a piece and rub it up in a man like this. Then rub it so. Just rest my hand. Yeah, just like this and fry. Yeah.
Now, do these raise up a bit too? Because they got the bacon powder in them.
Yeah, they come up a little bit.
Perfect.
Yeah, man.
Man, you look that up quick.
Yeah, man, we don't play, man. Right now, the pot over here, so I'm actually some cooking oil. Yeah, man.
The last couple days you've been here, Mokko's been getting a break. You've been doing all the cooking.
Yeah, man. You see that for true, man. Mokko getting a break, but when we come back, Mokko time for work.
Yeah, exactly. He's enjoying his vacation because when I'm here, it's full on, man.
Yeah, man. So end up on a little vacation now.
Yeah.
So when me come back, yeah, man, Mokko will do some cooking for me.
Yeah.
First two time, in some food, salt.
Yeah.
So, yeah, cause him no use the seasoning. Yeah, man, me here telling me soon go inside. Him no too use the seasoning. Then go natural. So I eat now last time I give him a natural food. Then me season the pot and him like it, you see. Yeah. But me give him our fish tea. Him say salt. Mm. Yeah, man. In a real life. And it tastes salt for true. That one day, him want to look at salt going in that pot. And then the next one now, him said that salt, well, me no really see salt now. Me know say the season or the night make him say it's salt.
Mm.
Yeah, man, so last night we gave him a nice one.
You enjoying this break, Mokko? Is it the same one you always had? No? I was gonna say, it looks a little different.
I hear the mint, you know. Blue, stone, they hear the mint. That is fire.
Yeah.
Back in Tanya Street, like in the sun, it got about 50 different vibes in it. When it went in the sun. See me know? Me know, you know. And see it now, sunrise, see me come back. That me want. See me? See how they change? That me ring they want, brother. See, they never change, you know, but me just. Me general say when things see them look like that, maybe just rub them with the alcohol and a real. And see it?
Come back.
Yeah, pokery.
Oh, wow, look at you, man.
What's that?
Right on.
You need to clean up.
Yeah. Wash it off, brace it up.
Yeah. And I keep the bowls on it.
Yeah.
When the rain falls, it doesn't pop down.
Mm-hmm.
put in some flour, you know.
Then you want it pretty hot, yeah?
Yeah.
Skeleton swim.
Yeah, skeleton swim.
Just give a bit of flavor for the oil.
Yeah, skeleton make it oil like a flavor, yeah, nice. It's a dumpling. Tastes nice. When you normally eat two, you have to eat three. Okay, you have that little thing there behind it, that little spice there. Yeah, man. Well, remember, anything you fry, you have to wait till the oil well hot.
You wanna use this?
And then you put in the stuff there. Eh?
Look at that, some professional moves. Yeah.
Yeah, man. I'm gonna make some cane roll too, you know, because I can make some little stylish flour too, you know. Yeah, man.
If you haven't seen Jason's channel, check it out, but he hosts people on his yard too.
Oh, yeah, man.
Tons of people from all over the world come visit you.
True, true. You don't know if my channel name Jamaica Sunrise TV. Yeah, man. In real life, love the cooking.
You just fixed up your yard real nice too, the brand new kitchen.
Yeah.
Check out that video, or there's a whole bunch of different videos on that one, man.
Yeah, man, whole heap, man.
Whole heap. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yes.
So we just make them to go and fry on the one. Whenever your feet say decide where they lay them and get enough, you just spin it over, and after that I take them out and put in some more.
How do you tell? It just gets a little brown on the edge,
yeah,
or
yeah, yeah, it just gets brown. But some people like it crisp. So if you get it crisp, I know you have to make it go extra brown. Yeah, so when I eat it, you don't pan crisp. But I like it, so I like to eat the dumpling, I know, so I feel the food with the inside. When it crisp, I just crispness, yeah, I eat crisp.
Yeah, it's a dumpling, not a biscuit, right?
Yeah, it's not a biscuit. It's not a biscuit, bro.
These ants better escape soon, because I don't know what they're doing in this piece.
You find a little brownness.
And you can feel even on the top, yeah.
Yeah, you can hear the difference. Yeah.
So the middle one's a little soft.
Yeah.
But the other ones are coming in hot.
So
look at that. Beautiful, man.
So yeah, look for that color of the beets. It's on. Yeah. So a lot of food is under this. Yeah, man, I have a picker. Broken piece of fire tick.
I better watch myself.
Yeah, let me see.
Yep. That's all you need?
Yeah, man. It worked just like an axe to you. Know.
Yep.
Get the fire blazing. I like when the fire blaze, peeps.
Do you always cook on fire at home too, or you do a gas as well?
You know, so I just love the outdoor cooking though. Yeah, man, I cook on gas when I kind of feel lazy. Yeah, I have a gas stove, but I cook outdoor, I cook like on two block and a big fire.
Yeah.
Crazy fire on the pot. People say, oh, you do it, you know, burn up the food. And it's like, no. Because I just catch it on a level. I'm born because my people my cook like how I cook. I saw my granny used to cook still, you know. My granny, they have a kitchen with two of them stove here. But me not use the jump pan, I just do it outdoor pan, two block. Yeah, man, big fire underneath pot.
Sweet.
Yeah, man, big flames. Yeah.
It's crispy how you want it?
Yeah, man. Nice, see fire, get up there now. I mean, I really like the whole heap of smoke in my eye and sitting, man. See it?
Beauty.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, man.
Oh, my. Perfect, huh? Man.
If you're too crisp now, you're not going to find this inside. It's going to go crisp, crisp.
Like a little crisp and a little soft on the inside. It's perfect.
Yeah, man.
Ratty, what are you up to?
Don't ride.
Some practicing. Nice. And yeah, your handwriting, it's neater than mine. for sure. 100%, 100%. I can't write, barely need it all anymore. I don't know what happened. I'm pretty fast typing, but my handwriting is downhill. What kind of bananas are these?
Frog banana.
Yeah, now I try and see if I can fry them. They look well ripe.
Yeah, they look super ripe.
Yeah, so I'm going to see what I'm going for them.
Do you taste them yet?
Not yet. He said, Mokko said this is good for shakes.
Oh, yeah?
Like when they're ripe like this. So Jason said he's going to try to fry it. We'll see.
We'll see.
But they're still going to taste delicious.
So look at that. Pan off the fire. That's a good technique. Because they're so ripe, Jason?
Yeah.
Mm.
So I can put them on them about catch color.
Mm-hmm.
So like when I put in all of them now, I just put it on back on the fire, so everything catch on one level more on them. And so I'm going to go with them and I'm going to line up in a meanwhile and start cutting up my cabbage.
Now I see tons of fried plantain in Jamaica. I don't see much fried banana straight up like
this. No, we mostly fried plantain. We don't really fry banana. We boil banana.
Mm-hmm.
We eat ripe banana and eat it. We don't really fry.
Yeah.
More time you find like some little kids at the moment they want banana chips, so they just get some banana and cut it up and throw in some island say banana chips, that yardman style. Nice too. Tip little salt pan here, little black pepper, gone. But otherwise we don't really fry banana. But I'm gonna catch little color, you know, in a piece.
Yeah, they're crisping up nice. They look just like the plantain.
Yeah, man, I'm gonna catch little color, you know.
Yeah, it's working.
Yeah, man, them looking good, peeps. And you know, so them have a taste good too. You just a little tip of salt on it or sugar. Any one of them you choose. Whether the salt or the sugar, it's a good nice.
Oh, man, them come back again pretty clean and crisp and clean. Oh, it's so fucked up, man. Clean and pretty again, man. Yeah, clean and pretty again. But then it's going to come back because if I'm here, I use all the ashes, a bush.
Mm-hmm.
The ashes make them shine to you now. Yeah, they put them on and they lick out the fish, them brain. If you all have one that shine, a spoon me use, a spoon, you know. A spoon when I eat with you, you know. Make this, you know. Spoon, eating spoon, you know. Good quality silver, you know. So I don't buy me directly, said, me get up and go buy them, you know. A spoon when I have from my yard, yeah. Make this ring when I have a heat my food, you know. And I know, say, oh, it's a shine. Shine with that silver, so I just take it and make the ring. Yeah. So I play with them, she me like, oh, I'm going to just make them, I'm going to just buy them too much in. And I went and I got this, I was long years.
Yes, fire ketchup here now. You know, you have to take them out. Yeah, when you fry them at the color, you have to look fine now. Yeah, so you look
nice.
And I burn them burn up now just the color you have to look for, because remember them well ripe.
Yeah, these ones are super, super ripe.
Yeah. And then brown, black. Yeah, man, see that fire just I get up there now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man, them one here can fry crispy, because you know, so through the meat soft inside, it can go fry, go to a limit. And if you don't take them out of the pot, then I go black like this and start burn.
I like them when they're a little crispy too. That's a little crispy.
Yeah.
That one got a little too far, but still gonna be good. The sweetness is still inside.
Fresh tomato, plenty cabbage for go steaming. Cut up some okra already when we just go pick from Mokko backyard farm. And some scallion, you know.
I never even knew we had an okra tree here.
Yeah, man, you have some okra tree on at the back there.
Hmm.
Yeah, man. See? I have some garlic same way.
One scratchy.
Yeah, one scratchy.
Rati's gonna show me the tree.
I've never seen okra tree before. It's my first time.
Watch your head on this razor. Oh.
Danger Bay.
Is this him?
Yeah, this is the okra tree. They're shooting.
Oh, I got okra flower. Wow. Yeah. Look at that. Growing upside down, or from what I imagined anyway. Just a little one starting right there. Whoa. Beautiful. Another big one. Huh.
Come over here. You're not afraid. This is not gonna fight you. Not this. Come over here. This is the salad farm.
So far.
The corn.
Uh-huh.
The corn. And this is the salad blooming.
Yeah.
And
wow, there it is. That's the sorrel.
Yeah, this is the white one.
Hmm.
White one.
Cool.
Sorrel the pandan.
That's awesome.
Yeah, and this is the corn. The corn.
We grow a lot of corn at home too. Love corn.
Yeah, the bush is 1 million. For real.
Wah. Oh yeah.
It's looking so good. I became a cabbage fan in Jamaica, really. I didn't care for it too much before, but ever since I came here, oof.
Whoa!
Yeah, man.
Sunrise!
Yeah, man, that's you, man.
Bless up, sir.
Yeah,
I can't wait. I've been watching the channel for a while, so now it's my turn to try the good stuff from the man himself.
In real life.
Real life. So, we got cabbage, frog banana,
and fried dumpling.
Fried dumpling.
Mm-hmm.
Ratty.
Yeah?
How's sunrise food?
Good.
Enjoying it?
Yeah.
10 out of 10?
Yeah.
I'll take the lack of words and just eating nonstop as a true statement. How's breakfast?
Excellent breakfast, man.
Yeah.
I'm very excited to try this. Sunrise boss, Jason, a little bit of pear for some nice natural fat in there too. So,
You have everything, man. You got a lot of that stuff for your body.
Man. So we got beautiful pear. I love to pair the pear with dumpling.
Mm.
Oh man.
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful, man. The cornmeal is a real nice touch to the dumpling because I'm used to the sort of softer dumplings when you get boiled food and that kind of thing. This is a nice one. Bit of crisp, a bit of soft, a little extra flavor, a different texture with the cornmeal. So,
chew.
Yeah. Come on. Nice cabbage, fresh okra from the yard. Frog banana.
Hey, when the temperature gets wicked enough, because it's in yard, you know, brother, and I eat when I have, you know, brother.
I'm giving Sunrise Boss a 10 out of 10 for food. So please go visit the man. I'll put the link down below. Well worth it. As soon as you can get to Jamaica and not deal with quarantine stuff, please give the man a visit. It's highly, highly recommended. I can't wait to go to his yard to try it right from his views as well. So see Sunrise Boss in his own element.
Yeah, man, I'm not going to spice. So everything where I cook, you know, I just have to cook it on a nice level. You can't too spicy, you know what I mean? Because I'm not going to too nice spicy thing. But when you come at my place now, straight spicy pepper and all of them things there, up at all time, you see? But otherwise, you know, just know, support my channel, you see, Jamaica Sunrise TV, and you know, go and share up the channel them, same way Ras Kitchen, yeah, man, and go and tell the world about it. Because you don't know, say, we out here, I put back Jamaica on the map. You see, the real way, yeah, man, up in the hills, country life nice, and also the river peeps, can't have talk about the river, nice. Yeah, man, in real life, man, the river nice, man.